Very nice to see you.
Pleasure.
Do you want to get you in the middle?
Yeah, right, let's go. Yeah, come on.
On your own.
Perfect, great. Right, two of them.
And then one in the middle with John, and done. There you go.
In the wake of the tragic death of Russian opposition leader Alexei Navalny, the international condemnation echoes across the globe. Norway joins the chorus of nations seeking answers as it summons the Russian ambassador to convey its concerns. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs has today summoned the Russian ambassador for a talk about the death of Alexei Navalny. In the conversation, Norwegian views will be conveyed about Russian authorities' responsibility for the death and for facilitating a transparent investigation, read the official statement issued by the Norwegian Foreign Ministry. Meanwhile, across the North Sea, the United Kingdom takes decisive action. In recent years, the authorities imprisoned him on fabricated charges, poisoned him with a banned nerve agent, and sent him to an Arctic penal colony. Alexei Navalny dedicated his life to exposing the corruption of the Russian system, calling for free and open politics, and holding the Kremlin to account, stated the spokesperson for the UK Foreign Office. Alexei Navalny was serving a 19-year jail term on extremism charges. Navalny, Putin's critic, met a tragic end in an Arctic prison colony at the age of 47. Russian officials claim his death was due to sudden death syndrome. His allies and family refused to accept the official narrative, alleging foul play and pointing fingers at Putin's regime. His wife, Yulia Navalnaya, says, "Help punish Putin and his regime." As the world mourns his loss, questions linger, and demands for justice grow louder even in the international community.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.